Welcome students, in this lecture we are going to study the topic that is excretion and osmoregulation. In previous series of lecture we have studied the different parts of that topic, that is excretory system, urine formation, or the various excretory organs in lower and higher animals. According to the human excretory system, the main excretory organ is kidney, or principal excretory organ is kidney. But in addition to this kidney, the skin and lungs also acts as a additional excretory organ, so they are also called as accessory excretory organ. Then what is the role of skin in excretion? The skin of lower animals shows presence of permeability for the different components of the excretory material, that is urea, uric acid, etc. But in case of higher animals, especially in case of human, the skin is thick and it is impermeable for such substances. Therefore, skin only permeable for the urea, lactic acid and salt or NaCl along with water. So, for that purpose, there is a presence of sweat glands and sebaceous gland within the skin. The sweat glands are simple tubular glands, which are coiled glands present below this dermis portion and opens outside by a pore called a sweat pore. From this sweat pore, sweat comes out on the surface of the body. Mainly such sweat glands are present on the facial region or on this palm region. म्हणजे काय बघा, आपल्या हाताच्या तळव्यावरती आणि चेहऱ्यावरती असणाऱ्या ज्या स्वेट ग्लँड्स आहेत त्याची संख्या जास्त असणार आहे. सो स्वेट ग्लँड्स आर मेनली प्रेझेंट इन लार्ज अमाउंट ऑर लार्ज इन नंबर ऑन द फेसियल रिजन ऑन अँड ऑन दिस पाम रिजन. देअरफोर स्वेटिंग फर्स्ट ऑकर्स ऑन दिस फेशियल रिजन ऑर इन ऑन द पाम रिजन. देअरफोर स्वेट ग्लँड्स plays an important role in the decreasing body temperature or increasing body temperature during seasonal or environmental temperature. It is one of the role of homeostasis or maintenance of internal environment constant, and it plays a main role in thermoregulation. So the function of sweat gland is maintenance of body temperature according to environmental temperature. By this mechanism is called as thermoregulation. Then second type of gland, that is sebaceous gland. This sebaceous gland secretes sebum, or it is oily substance secreted by the sebaceous gland. Such glands are mainly present in case of mammals at the base of hairs. The hairs are present on the skin in case of class Mammalia, and at the base of this hair or in neck region of this hair, there is presence of sweat sebum secreting glands, and these sebum secreting glands are opens on the surface of the skin which secrete oily substance, and this oily substance is called as sebum. This sebum maintains the softness of the skin, or it is also protect the skin from mechanical injury and infection also. So it secretes sebum, therefore it acts as an excretory organ in case of man in addition to this kidney. Then sweat gland secretes sweat. What is the secretion of sweat gland? It secretes sweat. It consists of NaCl. What is the chemical composition of sweat? It consists of NaCl, or it is also shown presence of lactic acid, or in small amount it shows presence of urea. All these are the chemical components present in sweat, and because of that component excreted by the skin acts as a accessory or additionally excretory organ in lungs with kidney. Then lungs, another organ, that is lungs. Lungs are the main respiratory organ in case of all vertebrates, but in case of human being or other vertebrates, lungs also releases carbon dioxide outside the body. In addition to this, some volatile substances are also excreted out by this lungs. Therefore lungs acts as a excretory organ in case of all vertebrates. Similarly in case of human being, in addition to this excretory organ, that is kidney, म्हणजे किडनीच्या बरोबर लंग हा सुद्धा एक्सक्रिटरी ऑर्गन आहे, कारण तो CO2, that is carbon dioxide, हा रेस्पिरेटरी गॅस आहे तो बाहेर टाकतोय, शिवाय व्हॉलाटाईल सबस्टन्सेस असतात. ऑल द व्हॉलाटाईल सबस्टन्सेस आर प्रेझेंट मेनली इन केस ऑफ स्पायसेस, दॅट इज ओनियन, गार्लिक. वेन वी इट सच सबस्टन्सेस देन देर इज ए सम पिक्युलियर टाईप ऑफ स्मेल कम्स आउट फ्रॉम दिस एक्सक्रिटर रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टीम. देअरफोर लंग्स ऍक्ट्स एज ए एक्सक्रिटरी ऑर्गन्स इन ॲडिशन टू दिस किडनी. इट एक्सक्रिट्स CO2 अँड सम व्हॉलाटाईल सबस्टन्स विच आर प्रेझेंट मेनली इन केस ऑफ स्पायसेस. सो दो द किडनी इज अन एक्सक्रिटरी ऑर्गन इन केस ऑफ ह्युमन बीइंग, इट इज मेन ऑर प्रिन्सिपल एक्सक्रिटरी ऑर्गन दॅट्स किडनी. बट इन ॲडिशन टू दिस द स्किन अँड लंग्स ऍक्ट्स एज अ एक्सक्रिटरी ऑर्गन. देन नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इन दिस टॉपिक, दॅट इज disorder and diseases related to this excretion and osmoregulation. Which are the different diseases related to this kidney? The main diseases mainly popularly occurs in case of different patient, that is presence of various types of stones, and such as stones are called as kidney stones, or these stones are also called as renal calculi. Stones are also called as renal calculi or renal stones. Such as stones are formed from the calcium, or such calcium stones, or they are steroid stones, or they are uric acid stones, or cystine stones. Then these are the various types of stones on the basis of their chemical composition, or the formation of that stone depends upon the which type of chemical is present within stone, or why such stones are formed. See here, first one, that is calcium stone. When blood calcium level increases because of the intake of high calcium diet, or because of the decalcification of bones, when blood calcium level increases, then such types of stones are formed, which are mainly formed from calcium oxalate or calcium phosphate. Then steroid stones. The steroid stones are formed by because of the infection of bacteria, which breaks the urea or splits the urea. By splitting of urea, such types of stones are formed, called as steroid stones, because of the presence of bacteria or because of this bacterial infection. The steroid stones are formed in which splitting of urea occurs. Actually, urea is an excretory waste material. It must release outside from the body by this excretory system. But without excretion, when it split into the different molecules or components, this splitting forms into the stones, and such stones are called as steroid stones, which are formed because of this bacterial infection. So a question may ask on that point, that is the stones which are formed by the bacterial infection are called as dash dash, that is steroid stones. Then uric acid stones. Mainly we are ureotelic, we excrete urea as an excretory material, but uric acids are also formed within the body because of this metabolism, and such metabolic byproduct, that is uric acid, is formed from the high intake of protein diet. When such uric acids are formed by within the liver, and this uric acid get accumulated into the different parts of the body, especially at the joint region, and causes joint pain, and such joint pains are called as gout disease. Or if uric acids are get accumulated within the any part of the excretory system, that is in a kidney or outside the kidney in ureter, then such accumulation of uric acid forms as stones, and such stones are called as uric acid stones, which are mainly formed from uric acid. And cystine stones. Cystine stones are mainly formed by the removal of excess amount of certain amino acids, and it is one of the genetic disorder transmitted from one generation to next generation. So such type of genetically formation of stones are mainly found in some families, and such stones are called as cystine stones. So these are the four types of stones, that is calcium stones, steroid stones, uric acid stones, and cystine stones. And out of these, one is bacterially, because of this bacterial infection called as steroid stones, and because of this excess releasing of specific type of amino acid called as cystine stones. So these are the various types of kidney stones or renal calculi caused by the accumulation of the various urea or uric acid inside the kidney, and abnormal intake of food material or diet. Then, which are the different symptoms related to the presence of stones? Then, physically presence of stone mainly causes the pains in abdomen, especially towards the backside below the rib cage, and these pains indicates the presence of stones. May such a presence of stone indicated by diagnosis process, that is X-ray method or sonography method, or it's mainly depending upon the color of urine, or what is the chemical composition of urine by checking urine, or the what is the chemical composition or of blood. If blood can tested, then it shows presence of uric acid, then maybe uric acid stone is present inside the kidney after sonography or X-ray method. Confirmation of presence of stones maybe occurs. Then what is uremia? See here, uremia means presence of urea within the urine. It mainly 0.01 to 0.03% of urea is present in blood normally, but above this 0.03%, that is above 0.05%, urea when present within the blood, that is it get increases up to 0.05%, then such condition is called as uremia. Specially definition, what is definition of uremia? The large amount of urea present in blood or increase the concentration of urea in blood is called as uremia, and this uremia also leads to the kidney failure. Then what is nephritis? Nephritis is nothing but the release of protein through the urine. Actually, in normal condition, proteins are not get filtered from this glomerular filtration. But when the ability of glomerular filtration when changed because of the injury in the kidney, then may proteins get filtered, and this proteinated urine is called as nephritic syndrome, or it is also called as albuminuria, and it is one of the indication of injury in the kidney, especially in the glomerular epithelium. Then there are various diseases related to the, some are short term diseases or long term diseases related to the kidney called as renal failure. Renal failure mainly divides into two types, that is acute renal failure and chronic renal failure, or it is also called as chronic kidney diseases. What is ARF? Acute renal failure and chronic kidney diseases. These are the diseases dependently classified on the basis of duration. If short duration kidney get failed, then such a condition is called as acute renal failure, and if there is a longer duration, continuously irreversibly decreasing the function of kidney, that is decreasing glomerular filtration rate, then such a condition is called as chronic kidney diseases. So these are the two different types of diseases because of the some attacks on the kidney because of the intake of toxic substances, toxic drugs, the kidney failure occurs, or long term failure because of the various toxic substances. If kidney get function defunction gradually, irreversible reaction which leads to the formation of small kidney or complete decrease in glomerular filtration rate, then such condition is called as chronic kidney diseases is long term disease, and acute renal failure is short term disease. Such type of diseases may diagnose by the creatinine level within the blood or in urine. If creatinine level in blood get increased, then such condition is called as acute renal failure, and if the kidney size get decreased and rate of glomerular filtration is get decreased gradually, irreversibly, then such condition is called as chronic kidney diseases. So these are the various diseases related to the kidney, and some accessory excretory organs, that is the skin and lungs in case of human beings and all higher vertebrates. Thank you.